having been treasurer for 3 unprecedented terms and ran a very good shop there, and working with the controller, with or without Republican or Democrat controllers, didn't matter. We worked cross party lines if need be to get the job done. I think we can make an impact here on an office where basically it's the epicenter of all finance for the state of Illinois at a time when the state is probably in its worst financial situation, where I think, you know, with the experience factor, with our proposals, many of which you'll read about in here, we'll discuss here as we go along, I think we can, you know, start trying to right the ship of state here. I don't think it's going to be an overnight type of a situation. I don't care who wins what. It took a long time to get to this point. I think it'll take a bit to clean it up, but I think we need to start and make it happen. I call my little program my estimated time of arrival, which is the ETA, for efficiency, for transparency, and for accountability. Then there's little subparts under all of that, which we think we can do. If you can do those things, run an office, bring it up to 21st century standards, because the computerization really and truly has to be brought up. That has not been brought up to date since 1996. I'm not going to tell you I'm some computer whiz, but it's my understanding they use something called a mainframe there, and they still use a computer language called COBOL, which apparently nobody speaks anymore. It's like Sanskrit. So I'm just assuming that there are some folks who are probably just who are kind of old who know that. But when they retire, is anybody going to know that? And then, of course, working with Dan Rutherford, who's running for treasurer, because he believes in this as much as I do, and we're going to work toward the combination of those two offices, it would be very, very good to have computerization that talks to one another. And we would set aside money every year for that, because it's not a cheap proposition to make happen. But you can do it in-house incrementally. We think we can, you know, put a good wedge into the pay-to-play and miscellaneous other things because of putting contracts up online, making sure everybody knows having a financial SWAT team that actually looks at these things on the front end rather than the back end. I have the greatest of respect for Bill Holland, love to work with him, will work with him, but by the time it gets to him, the money's already gone and the horse is out of the barn. If we can stop it, we've looked at some other states that have done versions of this. They've been able to save money, most specifically Colorado. They saved close to 3% of their contractual expenses. In Illinois, if we could do that, that would translate to Illinois to about $300 million. But anything we could save on that front would obviously be to our advantage. We want to make sure that people know what these contracts are, know what the payment cycle is. We would have something called an e-alert, asking vendors if they send a bill to an agency that they would send us a copy that we could post. Because right now, be it you or be it us, we really would not know what the agencies were hoarding. Forever, they have been stockpiling bills there, which don't go down in a timely fashion to the controller's office to avoid the Prompt Payment Act. So as a result, there's money out there, which makes it more than likely that we're more than $13 billion in the hole on day-to-day, probably more likely, you know, something greater that we still don't know. None of this works. Anything that we talk about here today, none of this works unless the state starts making some decent cuts and starts looking at some fiscal responsibility, most specifically in Medicaid. Medicaid is growing at 9% a year. It is eating up everything in sight. And it's unsustainable. And if we don't move that over to managed care and get our eligibility requirements in line with that of other states, then that's a $2 billion saving. That would be a major move on our part to start the processes of starting to get our budget in order and starting to get this state back to some kind of fiscal integrity. There's lots of things I think we can do to bring this budget into line. I certainly would try. I will work with whoever is governor. I will work with whoever is treasurer, whatever party they may be. We've always done that for the good of the order. And I think if every constitutional officer can do that and attempt to work together, you know, and as I said, working with Rutherford, we want to combine those two offices. We've gone about trying to do that. You know, that would take a constitutional amendment, but it's time to bring those two offices together. 4 years from now, you'd only have one of us if we could get that thing passed. I think the timeliness of it now and the pressures of the economy are such that, that it's time to make that happen. And frankly, I would throw the lieutenant governor's race into that as well. I think we could save $2 to $3 million and no need for that office as well.